None of this is random. I just put up Pelé, my childhood idol, there.
Red Rooster Harlem has exploded onto the food scene, in no small part due to the energy, charisma, and talent of its chef, Marcus Samuelson. He made his name at the Midtown restaurant Aquavie, and now Mr. Samuelson is showcasing his culinary roots from Ethiopia to Sweden to New York at this uptown restaurant.
This is not random. This is about curation. And so much about dining and so much about eating is about curation, because people don't have time and money is hard.
These days, Mr. Samuelson isn't just curating food, he's curating his brand. This is Adrienne Carter reporting for the New York Times. Mr. Samuelson is the modern celebrity chef. Along with six restaurants, he has four cookbooks, a line of teas, deals with MasterCard and American Airlines.
It's a very exciting menu. It's really a menu of Harlem.
He mingles with celebrities, the First Family, and regularly shows up on TV shows like Top Chef Masters.
My back was killing me. It took me about 10 minutes to get in the shower. It took me 20 minutes to tie my shoes. I was really worried.
And, you know, it used to be 20 years ago, before Food Network and all of those popular television shows, that a chef's role was really to run a restaurant, maybe write a cookbook, appear in a school to help school lunch programs. And now they are like the superstars of the television and media world. It's really amazing to see the impact that chefs can have, not only on their small communities, like Harlem for Marcus Samuelson, but on a nation as a whole.
Celebrity chefs today hope they can translate their personality and culinary talents into brands that consumers can access outside of the restaurant. With his growing multi-million dollar company, Mr. Samuelson is joining the ranks of Mario Batali, Bobby Flay, and Wolfgang Puck. It's a big business. Mr. Puck's pots and pans alone scoop up $50 million a year.
So not anybody can extend their brand. You have to appreciate that with retail, they're going to have to take somebody off the shelf to get you on the shelf.
Brand building is constant, high-energy work. Later this year, Mr. Samuelson will debut a line of cookware with Macy's and open a restaurant in Lincoln Center.
I'm very interested in Marcus. I want to watch him. I want to sit down, have dinner with him, and have him tell stories all night long. But when I pick him up, what Marcus Samuelson will I be picking up?
I've been lucky enough to have a dialogue with the public for about 20 years, and that's a privilege that I don't take for granted. When I go and think about in the history of people who've had that, and then you take a look at the people in history that have done that with food, and then you narrow that down to people that look like me, it's very small.
But I think the challenge for Marcus Samuelson is for somebody to say to him, you can do this, but not this, 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 and this.
Mr. Samuelson understands the challenges. As his business grows, he is aiming to balance the culinary and the commercial, as well as interact with the broader community.
Food connects, and it gives you a window in to understanding a subject that you maybe or may not have been that familiar with. But it opens a conversation, and it makes you look at a person from, wow, now I know who you are. I didn't know that about you.
Special salad one, soup two.